The Illuminati Formula to Create an Undetectable Total Mind Control Slave by Fritz Springmeier and Cisco Wheeler. Podcast 14. Chapter 7, The Science of Structuring. Continues. Next we will discuss how some of these types of alters are created. These will be discussed in alphabetical order. It should be pointed out that generally the Illuminati choose one of the early front gatekeeper alters to be the alter who knows the entire system as it is made. This often is gatekeeper number 3. After the entire structuring is finished, this alter will be hypnotically programmed to forget that they know the entire system. By the age of 10, an Illuminati system will have someone who knows the entire system. However, these gatekeepers get heavy programming not to remember. Angry alters. By the time the programmers are ready to create angry alters, the child victim has been well conditioned not to get angry, but to passively accept their abuse. The programmers have to get the child's mind to break with their prior programming to get angry. In order to do this, the child will be tormented without end for several days. This is one of the worst parts of the programming, and many children die in this stage. The Illuminati pick their most gentle mothers of darkness systems to work with the male programmers. If the gentle mothers of darkness slaves didn't bring some balance and affection to the child victims, the sadistic programmers would probably kill all of the children at this stage of programming. For more on this, see Egyptian armies just a little further. Animal alters means acting like animals. Although a large share of an alter system is dehumanized, there are certain alters which will be created to actually hold the body and act like animals. The alter may even be named animal. A male or female slave may have dog alters which bark like a dog and get into the correct position to allow a Rottweiler or German Shepherd or Doberman to penetrate the slave sexually. This is accomplished by taking menstrual blood from a dog in heat and smearing it on the victim. Animal alters are created by the standard dehumanization methods, and then shown films of what they are to become. Through hypnosis and behavior modification, the alters eventually accept the role they are tortured and programmed into taking. It's hard telling what roles the programmers have created. It could possibly be any animal, but cats, dogs, donkeys, horses, rats, and mice are common examples. Christian front alters. Most Illuminati systems have Christian front alters. Some of the early splits around 2 years of age are provided the chance to genuinely accept Christ. From these alters, two things will be done. Front alters who are Christians will be created, and satanic alters. In order to get dedicated satanic alters, Christian alters are severely traumatized and God is blamed for not helping them. The satanic alters will be deeply convinced that God has abandoned them. The Christian alters will dissociate all the trauma, and will believe that they are normal, nothing has happened out of the ordinary in their life. Christian alters will also, like all MPD/DID alters, tend to deal with overwhelming problems by dissociation. Many Christian alters will deny such basic things such as that a satanic conspiracy exists. They often will be far more zealous than the normal Christian, because they do not have conflicting ego states. If any situation calls for compromise of their religious beliefs, they can switch to someone else, and thereby escape having to compromise. There are many programmed multiples leading the Christian churches today. Christian alters are coached via the modern church and their handlers to only be spiritually minded and not to challenge evil in the natural world. Some walk around believing that God will cure everything, which is true but not in the sense that some of the churches are explaining. That doesn't mean that all systems will be polyanish, but it can happen. The original Christian alters will be shamed and then hidden by the programmers. The host or presenting alter which holds the body will often be a Christian. This really helps hide the entire mind control. Interestingly, a system of 20,000 alters may have only less than a dozen Christians alters, but the one or two strong Christian alters will exert a disproportionate influence on the system. The Illuminati has had a hard time controlling the Christian alters they allow. In their zeal to infiltrate, control and destroy the Christian churches, they have opened many of their top slaves up to the love of God, which has ended in the slaves trying to break free. Unfortunately, most ministers know too little to help these people escape. Clones. The clones are little children who have been put into robot costumes and are trained to attack parts of the system which are not in compliance with the programming. The heads of the clones can be unscrewed. The clones can be taken out by various tactics, but there are hundreds of clones and they each have been numbered. The serial numbers are placed on them. An example of a clone's number at the base of the neck might be 158.00. This may either be a model or actual serial number, but often is tied to the birthdate of the victim, which is generally part or all of the victim's monarch serial number. To create the clones during the 1950s, movie scenes of the divers of the Nautilus of the movie 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea were shown. With later models, such as in Star Wars programming, the robots of these shows suffice. Some clones kill with a knife as the divers in the movie 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. When clones surface and take the body, they are cold. Programming is encased in a clone. Altars, particularly cult altars, may not be able to see the clones. They may be hidden in almost anything internally, including doorknobs and walls. However, there is the possibility for the therapist that a net made of cloth woven of light can be dropped and the lumps will reveal the clones. They may be behind mirrors too. Water has certain properties that can stop clones, as well as magnets. Microwaves will take care of the electronics. A little microwave can take out a group of clones. Clones have many shapes, but they do not look like people. They usually have a switch to be activated. Atlantis may be set up as the world for clones, in accord with 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea programming. Whatever the style, robots and clones are popular items for programmers to install. One of the major defects of the first few decades of Illuminati programming was that the clones were set up so that water would stop them. Therapists could stop the clone armies by applying water on them. Recent models have corrected that deficiency. But when the clones are stopped, and the diver suits are taken off of the child altars, who are inside of the robot suits, then a child altar will be found which is in the same drugged state that it was in when it was being programmed. This child fragment altar will often have an IV, wires and needles, in it, and will be very druggy. It will be in its programmed warlike angry state. In Druidism, a swan was something dirty like a pig in Judaism. Some altars which are assigned to protect, are warned they will become swans. If the queen of the clones becomes a swan, the clones will become helpless. The queen of the clones, a triad, must do her job or be turned into a swan. Changing subjects to alter clones, cloning programs include, for instance, lollipop and lobster programs. Deltas. The deltas are alters trained to carry out special missions resulting in death. The deltas who are inactive are asleep. They must be activated. The programming to activate them will be triggered if a mission is given or if certain parts of the deeper parts of the system are tampered with. Deltas will work as a team with the betas to kill. An Illuminati system will be magically twinned during programming to be a twin with another system's delta alters. And these two systems in turn are joined in programming with another two-person team, so that two-person and four-person teams can be constructed. This gives the Illuminati more flexibility in what kind of missions it can send its slave out on. Four-person assassination teams are very common. They had two- and four-man monarch slave assassination teams at Waco, Texas the day that the Waco Branch Davidian building burned up. How the deltas are created. Illuminati deltas are linked to the Moon Children, and are the offspring of the Moon Child Altar in the early cage programming. In the early 1950s, the Illuminati would take a child and force it to watch another child, who they have bonded with, be incinerated alive in a crematorium at high heat, which would not only melt the child but turn it to ashes. The form of the child in ashes would stay in the shape of the child until the crematorium door, which would have glass in it for viewing, would be opened. A small gust of air would cause the ashes to lose their shape. Watching through glass and feeling the fire and hearing the child scream was a trauma for any child. The Presidio and some of the Illuminati-run funeral homes which had this type of crematorium were employed for fire traumas. The fire trauma was done so that the child would visualize melting from heat. This melting trauma would then form the basis of the good witch/bad witch programming, where water on a witch makes her melt like in the Wizard of Oz story. The delta and beta alters are then to trance into their melted state whenever their programmers want them to function. Their functioning state is the melted state. The programming is that the witches melt down to nothing. After a few years, the programmers realized that they didn't have to have a real trauma to get the programming done, because they could usually do it with a combination of hallucinatory drugs, hypnotic drugs, and paper dolls. Paper dolls which when cut out are all joined together would be placed on a grid similar to an altar grid on a platform. The right hypnotic suggestions are made, and the child believes these paper dolls are alive and are burned up. If the paper dolls didn't work, they'd go back to using a real child to get the job done. Later, the lower cat altars are taught how to be hunted and hunt at the life or death Beltane hunts. These hunts help train altars which are then used to create the deltas. The deltas are not completed until later. To create a trained assassin, altars were desensitized towards pain and death by being shown gory films with the eyes forced open. Hypnosis was also used. The potential victims were devalued. It is believed the Aryan altars, which are very elitist and racist, are used for delta altars. Satanic rituals were also involved in the creation of deltas. The deltas will be trained in hand-to-hand combat and know certain vulnerable places to kill people, including breaking the neck. Training included a great deal of weapons training. In an early programmed multiple system, which was created and programmed in Nazi Germany in the 1930s, the assassination altars are placed behind a wall of ice. When the wall of ice is melted, these assassination altars are freed and they will go about their assignment to kill by using an ice pick type needle poked into the heart of their prey. These systems were infiltrated into the US during the 1930s to build a foundation for when the Nazis expected to win the war. Later, American Delta altars were taught the art of assassination by poking a needle through the eye of the victim. This kind of assassination is apparently hard to detect. How the deltas are activated. The access codes for the deltas are structured different than for the rest of the system, except for the sexual and entrapment and espionage altars, who are designed very similar. The deltas may be black color coded. When the programmer wants to use these delta altars, he will call them up from their genie eye bottle or wherever they are hidden deep in the mind. They will be commanded to melt. When they have melted into the nothing state, then the programmer gives an exact script of everything the delta altar is to do, just like you would program a computer step by step, from step A to step Z. For instance, the programmer might say, at a certain place you will be in the melted state until you hear the words, "I'm going to Kansas City, where are you from, Miss Ruby Shoes?" At that point you will remain in the melted state and do part B of the script. As the programmer continues with the script, a delta fragment will be given NWO codes, bank account numbers, and major sports numbers, so other NWO folks know who is going to win ahead of time. This fragment will simply be a mental floppy disk. The delta beta alters are habitually lied to by their programmers when they are given their detailed scripts. If they are carrying cocaine, they may be told it is soap for needy children. If they shoot someone, then they will be told all kinds of lies about the person they are to kill. They never are really given a chance to step outside of their deep trance and to ever hear the truth about what they are doing. They live their lives in a surreal fantasy world where nothing really makes sense. They don't try to think for themselves, they just follow orders. Since a mission may call for other altars to hold the body, the programmer must put together his delta script so that two scripts can be intertwined. The programmer may work out something so that the delta alter goes into a temporary sleep in the melted state while out on the mission. This way the programmer doesn't have to be present on the trip to bring the delta alter back into its functioning melted state. The delta alters can't be out too long anyway because they are not used to functioning in the outside world and they get tired fast. Several delta alters can switch so that they keep having a fresh delta alter come out, but eventually everyone begins to get tired. That is another reason they will work in another script with front altars. The front altars are used to holding the body every day. The front altars will take a vacation, while the deltas work on their detailed script of carrying secret messages and maybe killing someone. During an airplane trip, a travel altar will hold the body while the delta sleep in the melted state. Delta altars, who by the way have photographic memories, are given their scripts by programmers, not run-of-the-mill handlers. Everything is too fine-tuned in the programming for a run-of-the-mill handler. Delta altars have an internal hourglass. This hourglass may be a mural in their internal world that they look at. As long as they are obedient, the hourglass sands do not fall. If they are disobedient, the sand begins falling, and their life is on the line. There is no room for mistakes. If the sand runs out, death is to happen. Large hourglasses are often displayed in front of Delta Beta slaves to remind them that there is no room for mistakes, no slack for disobedience. Their thinking is buried in fairy tales. They are programmed to see themselves in fairy tales, they are programmed not to see their handlers or anybody else's face for that matter. Their handlers pretend they are fairy tale characters or aliens. These alters do not have a chance to understand what they are doing. If the programmers get tired of the slaves' programming breaking down, and it does in part due to the severe abuse they get from these sadistic programmers and handlers, then they will simply give the slave an assignment in which the slave will end up dying, i.e. a suicide mission. This type of suicide mission is happening all over the United States with great frequency. An example would be a lady who is getting too wise about the New World Order, so a Delta is assigned to crash their car into the lady, and it's written down as just an unfortunate accident with fatalities. A shop owner refuses to pay the mafia for protection, so a Delta vandalizes and tears up the shop and has a fatal shootout with the police. Foreign language alters. The Illuminati and intelligence agencies realized when they started making slaves with photographic memories that they could create different parts of a slave's mind to operate on different languages. Illuminati hierarchy systems will employ foreign language alters for several purposes. A. To facilitate the alter working in various situations, for example, French is helpful to work with Catholics in Quebec, and with the Cambodian and Vietnamese criminal syndicate that the Illuminati set up in this nation. A high-profile example of this is Bogritz, an officer of the Delta Force, who due to his photographic mind, created via brainstem scarring, can speak Mandarin Chinese. Mandarin Chinese is not normally an easy language for Americans. B. To hide things in a system. Examples of this include code words attached to Greek and Hebrew letters for body programs. Another example is having Latin phrases for accessing deeper parts. If an entire area of a system is put in a foreign language, and the system is not given any alters capable of translation, then you have very effectively isolated an entire section. For instance, systems are being created in their early teens which are sectioned off into five or more languages, say for instance, German, Spanish, French, Italian, and Arabic. Some of the systems created in the late 1950s, already were employing some of this. Since the very best Illuminati programmer in the world is European, and speaks several languages, you can expect to start to see more and more of this Tower of Babel programming, multi-language systems where parts can't communicate. The reader realizes that such multi-language capabilities are always secret until the person starts breaking down the programming. The programmers tell alter systems that God wants this programming done, because God confounded all the languages and then spread people into the four corners of the world. Gatekeeper alters. The gatekeeper alters are just that. They protect the gates or portals to all system levels. Infrequently, the programmers may also call them doorkeepers, or toll men and toll women. The victim may refer to them as guards or blockers, although gatekeepers are more than guards, they are an entrance or portal to something. Gatekeepers may often be the altar that was split to get a particular section. Each gatekeeper may be at a deeper level trance than the one before it. When a gatekeeper is split, it creates a natural link to the altars that are created from itself. Then the gatekeepers are given programming not to see what they have created sound like this: black knight moves two spaces and one right. White knight moves two spaces and one left. White knight challenges black knight. Black queen moves five spaces. The victim who receives this programming must be the type of thinker who would play chess reasonably well. The script can be shown via videos while the victim is under hypnotic drugs. F double helix. This is a very important system. The double helix pattern is used as an elevator shaft running up and down the worlds created for the altars. In general, each world lays at a trance level. The double helix is put in at programming sites where they have full medical facilities, such as Letterman Hospital, Presidio, California. The codes up and down the elevator are alphanumeric with lots of numbers. Because the way the double helix shape twists, one can ride the elevator and get off a level 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, but you have to ride it the other way to get off at 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Because the double helix is the centerpiece of how the different physiological states of the mind are being layered, taking the victim down to these different physiological states and levels is very risky, and by the time it is through, it involves lots of blood transfusions for the victim. The caduceus is a double helix with snakes at the top. The caduceus is an occult symbol used in ancient Babylon, ancient Hindu India, and by Chinese occultists. Mercury in occult lore carries a staff called a caduceus. Mercury's staff is a Kabbalistic symbol. William Heller's book on the Kabbalah on page 78 states, "Mercury's staff, called caduceus and made of intertwined black and white twin serpents, heralds more forthcoming splits into duality." Once again, it reflects the ambivalent mind, its conscious and subconscious states, its waking thoughts and imaginative dreams. So according to Kabbalistic doctrine, the caduceus represents the various states of the mind. G flower system. This system is attached to other systems and utilizes the power of peer pressure and generational ties. The flowers will often be bright. The bud of the flower will represent one person, the stem and the flower represent others. This system might be connected to the umbrella, the trees, the triangle, and the star. A flower can regenerate an internal tree because of its generational roots. Flowers are also used as elevator shafts, such as a sunflower. One has to jump into the center of the flower and go down the stem to reach a lower level. Flower fields such as the poppy field are used as a hypnotic trigger to put an altar into deep trance. H helix. This is a simplified version of the double helix. I hourglass. Three hourglass will be placed around the XYZ axis in a quadrant. A quadrant consists of a section of altars in a world and their mirror images. The hourglass programming also includes a suicide program. 12 disciple altars will be placed within the hourglass. Each disciple has to memorize a disciple lesson. If something triggers them, they will begin to fall through the hourglass. If each of these 12 disciples falls through the hourglass like sand, then a sleeping giant like in Jack in the Beanstalk will wake up. When the giant awakes, he will kill the body. And of course, a mirror image of the giant altar will be made also to help ensure that at least one of the giants get the job done. J Mensa. This is a program put into slaves who have photographic memories. It involves lots of numbers and math. Its overall structure looks like a triangular shaped fish net, with all the nodes or knots of the net containing a triangle. The core is placed at the center of the triangle and is surrounded by more triangles. There are circles of altars within circles of altars. Circles within circles. The circle can rotate and seems never to end. The programming is meant to be non-ending. There are also triangles within triangles. The effect of using a structure like this to house the altars is that they feel trapped in endless circles and mazes of triangles within triangles. The codes in a Mensa system will be equations, sometimes called union force codes, barcodes, and number sequences. K pentagram system. One pentagram system has pentagrams within pentagrams. The geometric lines grow from pentagram to pentagram by lines running in opposite directions. This has the same effect as circles within circles. L. Pool of Death. One or more of these can be placed into an altar system. They often are found inside the main castle. Dead altars and body parts and torture fragments are all dumped into these system garbage dumps. The spirits of death and destruction control these pools of death. Variations of this may be called lakes of death and waters of death. In some systems, this is overseen by taskmaster altars. M. Potter's Wheel. This is the equivalent to a computer utility program. The way it functions is that the programmer pulls the altars he wants to work on up on the potter's wheel in order to work on them. When they are pulled up on the potter's wheel, they can be asked to stand in order and rank. Then the altars will come to the front of the mind on top of each other in their prearranged sequence. The charismatic movement programmers like to use this, because the programmer can become God, and the slave becomes the clay. Can the pot talk back to the potter? The Bible verse in Isaiah 45:9 is used, "Woe unto him that striveth with his maker! Let the potsherd strive with the potsherds of the earth. Shall the clay say to him that fashioneth it, What makest thou? Or thy work, He hath no hands." The next verse again repeats its woes upon those who question parents who fashion a child. As is typical of a number of Illuminati programs, at first glance they look like they are merely perversions of the Bible, but a closer look reveals that they are actually ancient occult rituals. For instance, the Illuminati believe as above, so below. This is Druidic philosophy, even though it sounds somewhat like something from the Bible. In the book Invocation of the Gods, Ancient Egyptian Magic for Today, p. 203, the book gives a magical invocation that supposedly has been found in ancient Egyptian magical papyri. At any rate, this invocation's wording is powerful in English for a monarch slave. The invocation is called the Potter's Wheel. Hear the sound of the potter's wheel as it spins. Num. See the clay on the potter's wheel as it spins. Num. Feel the hand of the mighty Lord form the seed to contain a soul as it spins. See the soul, on the wheel of life as it spins. Num. Birth to death on the wheel of life. See the soul, on the wheel of life as it spins. And with death we are born anew. While the vessel that's tossed aside will return to the potter's wheel as it spins. This is just one more example of where programming and magic intersect. And puppet system. In this system, the body feels totally disjointed and controlled by strings. Mengele enjoyed this program. He would say, "Dance marionette dance." In other words, to paraphrase, "Dance slave for me the controller." Demons are laid in to pull the strings of the puppet. The internal controller may be a demon or a demonized altar. It can be attached to other systems such as the pentagram system. In a previous part of the book, it was discussed how the victim's body is paralyzed by drugs and then electroshocked in a way that the person seems to be the programmer's puppet. This is put in when the child is very young. This puppet programming is very convincing to a small child, and is a very nasty program for the slave to experience. O Soul Metric System. This is used for government/business/research slaves who must perform complex tasks and they want their minds to be less fragmented or not fragmented. The mind can be programmed and divided from itself without creating alter personalities. Because the divisions in the mind due to dissociation and programming lies are not as deeply structured, victims who get soul metric systems have strong demonic forces and lots ritual to hold their systems in place. P. Spider Web System or Black Widow Spider System. This system is set up just for blackmail and destruction via entrapment of unsuspecting people who are perceived as threats to the Illuminati. This system is found in lots of women coming into churches with decent by naive ministers. The system has a web with connectors and silk strands. A target person will be symbolically placed into the web and then the Black Widow altar, S, will entrap the victim. This is programming to take down pastors of churches with sexual entrapment. The spirit viper found in Isa 59:5 is placed into the system to protect it. There will be egg altars which will devour the victim, and gatekeepers are assigned to guard the system. Q. Spiritual structuring. The spiritual structuring is not a single structure. A few people have worked with the deeper elements of the programming to help victims and also know what the Illuminati programmers have done and what their agenda is, have come to realize that the spiritual structuring is the most important part of an Illuminati system. What you will now read is known only to an exclusive few. Spiritual castles, grandfather, father, mother, and grandmother castles, and spiritual temples, to Moloch and Baal, etc., are constructed internally. Entire spiritual worlds are constructed internally. The most primal parts of the mind, and the key early altars and the core essence are usually taken to spiritual constructs within the Illuminati slave. The gems are empowered by the light of Lucifer, an altar demon combination. But even more deeper than that are the generational ties. The programmers, who themselves are generational Satanists, are part of a plan where the generational legal rights of Satan are accumulated upon an individual. In the scriptures it says that the sins of the fathers are visited upon the third and fourth generation. This gives Satan a legal right to the generational victim. Each bloodline has its prince demons attached to it, just like in the Bible the prince of Persia was both a man and a demon. Hidden within spiritual constructs such as black diamonds, and diamonds, are further demonic constructs. The thrones of the generational prince demons are attached to the primal human part of the victim. This is entirely spiritual beyond that there are no words to describe it. It is very real to the survivor when therapists get to that point, which is very rare. The power of the Illuminati is that it is generational. They build upon that, when they build a system. Some of these genealogies have not been free for many generations. If you want to spoil a structure, one need to bind the strongman. The strongman in an Illuminati system is the generational ties. All ties to the bloodlines need to be renounced. The programmers will take little Illuminati children to crypts of their ancestors in order to better attach the generational spirits. The womb holding the premature child is used as a temple in the moon child ceremonies. After the child is born, the womb structure will spiritually serve as a temple for the primal human parts of an Illuminati slave. Whether the therapist can realize these things or not, in the very least, they are aware of the saying father like son, and are aware how traits may skip a generation but how a grandson may mirror a grandfather. The generational aspects to Illuminati slaves are a major role in the Illuminati. Our stairwell. The stairwell is just as it sounds. It is a stairwell that is placed into a system. The stairwell can be used as a trap for alters who are unwise enough to be lured by programming to go into it. The stairwell system connects various levels. There are booby traps and demonic entities attached to the system. Stairwells may be sealed up with gatekeepers assigned to protect them. If an alter proceeds down a stairwell to get to other levels, they need to realize that they initially will hit tornado, also called whirlwind, programming and flooding of memories. The tornadoes will spin the victim inward and disorient them. The altar holding the body will feel as if it is out of control and going to die. S. Telescoping. Any telescoping object, such as a telescoping army drinking cup, or a telescoping rod, can be used to give the visual picture for the child to follow when it is being programmed. A telescoping system often has a time level, a function level and an age level. The game of chutes and ladders along with Jacob's ladder have been used to place the storyline into children. T. Tornado system. This is a free-floating system that moves around areas that the programmers want protected. When it hits an altar, it causes confusion, spinning, and switching as well as a feeling of losing control. It is part of the elemental backup programs discussed within a few pages. U umbrella. This is associated with military programming. An umbrella protects something, such as the Delta assassination altars. An umbrella must be taken down from the inside and so must this protective shield of the umbrella program. One umbrella system had 7 gates to it.